exactly is that?
Hashimoto's is an autoimmune phenomenon where the body is actually attacking the thyroid cells. And here we see two of the effects of the disease. One is the enlargement of the thyroid gland, and number two, you see here the pituitary is sending substantial signals to the thyroid to increase the production of the hormone. And that may be the reason for the enlargement of the gland. So it's a twofold phenomenon. It's the underproduction, the hypertrophy or enlargement of the gland, and the pituitary's response to generate more hormone.
What is it that would start something like this happening? What begins at the ground level of Hashimoto's disease?
It is the body's reaction against the thyroid, creating antibodies against it. So it's basically your body is attacking itself, in particular, in this case, the thyroid gland.
Is there anything specific? Are we talking about type of individual, lifestyle, anything specifically that's at the core of Hashimoto's?
We do know that it's associated with autoimmune diseases. So patients who have diabetes, who have lupus, or have any of the other plethora of autoimmune diseases are at risk of having this. And this tends to be more common in women and tends to be more common in their 40s and 50s.
We've also talked about symptoms of just about everything else here. Is there any symptoms of Hashimoto's that sets this apart from some of the other issues that we've talked about?
Enlargement of the gland, which may be visible. There may be some tenderness associated with the neck itself, as well as all the other symptoms of hypothyroidism.